Hello everybody, King Chiggy here, and welcome to another one of my Pokemon X and Y speculation videos. Last night, or I guess actually technically this morning, the Korokoro magazine for this month came out with a bunch of new information on the games, and I don't really think that what's been revealed up till now will be all of it, but you know, everything that's been revealed so far has been confirmed, so I'm going to talk about what we have now. And then later on, if more comes out, then I'll make another video. So, I guess I'll start with the least controversial things, and then we'll move on from there. So, the first thing we have is three new Pokemon. First off, we have the pre-evolution of Go-Goat, and right now, we only have the Japanese names for them all, so the pre-evolution of Go-Goat is Mikuru, and you know, it's a cute little grass goat thingy. And then we have the electric rodent for this generation, or you know, at least the first one. I don't know if it'll have a pre-evolution or a counterpart or an evolution or whatever, but this one is actually an electric fairy type named probably gonna butcher the name, Dedenne. I don't know, it's D-E-D-E-N-N-E. I don't know, but I actually like this one. It kind of looks like a little fat Raichu with a long tail and antennas coming out of its cheeks, but it's called the Antenna Pokemon, and it's going to have the pickup ability and a new ability called Cheek Pouches, which I don't know. When I think about that, I think about like berries or storing food or something, so it might have like an ability that allows it to use or wait to use a berry. I have no idea, but the third one is a normal type, not a fairy, thank God, and it's based on a rabbit. It's called the Digging Pokemon, and its name is Horubi. I think I got the name right. I don't know, it's a little gray rabbit with brown feet and brown ears, and I don't know, it looks kind of cute. And it's also going to have the abilities Pick Up and Cheek Pouches, so it looks like a lot of rodents might end up having the Cheek Pouches ability. We're going to have to see what that you know, entails. But, and also, it's also been confirmed that Mile is going to be steel and fairy type, which, you know, I kind of see it making sense. I mean, a lot of people might get aggravated that, you know, a lot of Pokemon are getting the fairy type, but I feel like, you know, Mile, it's been a while since anything's happened with Mile. And I feel like it getting the steel type might actually make it a little more useful, a little more likable. And, you know, it kind of fits with the idea that it's based off a Japanese monster of a woman that has a mouth in the back of her head. So, yeah. And, you know, I guess now we will move on to the more controversial things. In this issue, for these games, there has been a new evolution method revealed, and these new evolutions are called Mega Evolutions. Now, it hasn't been confirmed yet, or at least I don't think it's been confirmed yet, if these Pokemon are actually evolving or changing forms. I think they're changing forms because it shows Mewtwo evolving through this Mega Evolution, but in previous, you know, when the new Mewtwo was shown, it was considered a new form. So I'm thinking that this isn't actually an evolution per se, since everything in the article on Serebii has it in quotes. So I think it might just be a way of Pokemon to change form, maybe get stronger, maybe have their attributes change a little, but the Pokemon that it showcases right now with Mega Forms are Blaziken, Lucario, Absol, Mawile, Mewtwo, and Ampharos. And, you know, some of the evolutions are pretty drastic, like Blaziken changes color, it gets these flaming ribbons coming off of its wrists, and its hair completely changes, and you got, like, Lucario, who's covered in red and has, like, I don't know, Giratina wings coming out of the back of its head, and I don't know, it's got a cape. I'm not too crazy about the Lucario evolution. And then you have, like, Ampharos, who, it's kind of tame. It's like, you know, it's based on a sheared sheep, but this one, it's like the wool moved up to its head and down to its tail. Now it looks like it has, like, a long mane of hair coming off of it. It's got the big poofy tail now that's got the little light-up orbs in it. I don't know. I guess, you know, I don't really need to explain it since you can see it in the pictures, but these mega evolutions, you know, they come with different things and abilities. Like, Mega Mile is both going to be Steel Fairy, and I'm not completely sure if they're going to name everything, like, Mega, insert Pokemon name. I'm hoping that it will just be, like, they keep the name, and then, like, in the Pokemon description, it'll have, like, a little M or something to show that it's, like, a Mega form or something. But, back to the point. Mega Mile is both Steel and Fairy, and, Mega Blaziken has Speed Boost. I don't know if that's going to be its only ability, if it completely drops Blaze altogether. Mega Lucario has Adaptability. I don't think that normal Lucario had that. I think both of its abilities were, or had to do with flinching or being hit by Dark-type moves. I don't remember. But I think it might have had a Dream World ability that was Adaptability. I'm not completely sure. I don't know much on Lucario. But Mega Absol, which I think looks amazing. I'm glad that this thing got a new evolution because, holy crap, Mega Absol looks just stunning. It's going to have the ability Magic Bounce, which, you know, that's going to be pretty cool. And along with the Mega Evolutions, there's a new gym leader that's been shown. Her name is Karuni. At least that's her Japanese name. And she appears to be based on a rollerblader. She's got rollerblades on and a helmet. I'm not too sure what she's going to be based on, like her type, or even if she's going to have a type. This generation might be going so far off the path that they might feature gym leaders that specialize in stats instead of, you know, types. So she might be the first gym leader to specialize in speed stats. So, you know, just using really fast Pokemon. I don't know. But, she has been, or it's mentioned that this gym leader holds the key to understanding Mega Evolutions. So, my previous theory when I first saw the Mega Evolutions come out was that it was a Team Flare thing. I mean, when you look back at Generation 2, you could see that, Team Rocket had, you know, created a radio wave that forcibly evolved Pokemon, and that is at least what created the shiny Gyarados, and at the time, I think it was understood that that might have created the shiny Pokemon in general. I don't know, that I might be just coming up with theories in my head, but I like to think that it was Team Rocket that created the shiny Pokemon. So what if it's actually Team Flare that creates these things called Megastones, which I'll get to in a minute, that can make Pokemon evolve further into more powerful versions. Now, there are, where am I going with this? There's, you know, this, I had this idea that, what was it? That these Mega Evolutions were going to be, well, I said earlier that they were going to be form changes, not really evolutions. At least that's what I think. So, it's not like there's going to be like four evolutions in a line now. I don't think they would go that far. But I had the idea before that Pokemon X and Y was going to be based on genes and genetics. So it might be that I had the idea that Team Flare under the assumption that they were just out to make money, were actually out to create stronger Pokemon, and by doing that, they were messing with Pokemon genetics, created the Megastone, which would allow them to create more powerful Pokemon, and therefore be able to top any of their competition. Now, I don't know if that's true, since there's a gym leader that's said to have the key to understanding Mega Evolutions, but it could be the idea that this gym leader maybe works for Team Flare, and, you know, or she's just been observing what they're doing and kind of knows what's going on. So, If you have any ideas on that, let me know. I know my ideas aren't really the best, but, you know, they're what I have to run on. And so, along with these mega evolutions, there's something called super training that's going on. It just shows the facility. I think it's in the image with the three new Pokemon. I think it's down there at the bottom. I think it might just be like a training facility where you can battle your own Pokemon against each other, which I think would be pretty spectacular. And let's see here. The last thing I guess I should mention it is that the first event for Pokemon X and Y has been announced. It's going to be running from October 12th to January 15th, and it's for a Torchic that is distributed with a thing called the Blaziken Knight. Now, I'm not too sure if that's like a placeholder name for the Megastone, or I don't know. They said that it will have the ability to evolve into Mega Blaziken, which leads me to believe that not all Pokemon of the same type can evolve into a Mega Evolution. It might be Pokemon that have a specific ability, like maybe only Speed Boost Blaziken can evolve into the Mega Blaziken. I don't know. But it mentions that it can utilize something called the Mega Stone, which I guess is going to be the stone that evolves these Pokemon. I don't know if it's an actual item that you use on the Pokemon, or if it's going to be like the Mossy Stone and the Icy Stone that evolve Eevee, where you have to train around them, and that will cause the evolution once it levels up. It may be that there are specific items catered to the Pokemon that can turn into Mega Pokemon, like the Blaziken Knight item that a Combusken or a Blaziken has to be holding and then training around a Mega Stone to evolve it. Or it could be that, you know, it has to be holding this Blaze Knight item and then you use a Mega Stone on it to evolve. I don't know. There's a lot to speculate on. There's a lot of ideas going on here. And, you know, there's a lot to think about. So, I think that's all I have to talk about right now. I can't think if there's anything else I forgot. I'm looking at the page right now, and I don't think there's anything I forgot about. So, I think that's going to be it. Leave your ideas in the comment section if you'd like to. I'd really like to hear your thoughts and ideas on this. And, yeah, thank you all for watching, and I will see you all later.